Hey guys, welcome back. This video is going to be a little different because today is Halloween. Yeah, so since it's Halloween, I decided to create a special data pack for you guys. And this data pack is a boss fighting data pack. It has multiple overpowered attacks such as annoying vexes and predictable but potentially fatal pumpkin missiles. Although the boss cannot move, he has so much health that the players may die multiple times, but if you kill him, he drops a very special item, which I'm not gonna tell you until you actually kill him. So let's get started. First of all, I wanted to code the summoning of the boss. So when you drop two blaze rods, one wither star, and one pumpkin, carved pumpkin I mean, it will summon the boss. And basically it's like that floor crafting thing. I decided to go one step further. I would add an end crystal beam that would shoot up at that exact location. I also added some sound, and I also added lightning. Since I used a carved pumpkin in my summoning, I decided to make my boss a pumpkin type of boss because I summoned it with a carved pumpkin. Now, basically, this boss would be able to use Halloween or pumpkin related attacks. The first one I thought about was the annoying baby zombie pumpkin to resemble pumpkin minions, but I was too lazy to make a custom name, so we'll just stick with this. I decided our second attack would be a planned type of attack, where you see those indication markers on the ground to show where the boss is attacking. Now, this indication marker basically strikes lightning at the location. And it's really overpowered if you're not looking at where you are. Of course, you can easily avoid it. It's going to be represented by a clock right now. I'll remodel it later because I'm just doing the attacks right now. The next attack would be actually pretty overpowered. This attack is basically a missile attack. The boss shoots pumpkins at random players and it's pretty fast, but you can see where it comes from. When this pumpkin hits you, it explodes. And the explosion can send you into the air. Our fourth attack is a pumpkin storm, basically the same thing as the pumpkin missile, but this time it's literally just bombing. I had to test this one out with command blocks before I actually tried it out because I didn't want anything destructive. Remember, this is supposed to be a really hard boss fight. Of course, if you are prepared, you can survive this, like blast protection. It also has a marker as well to see where the pumpkins are, so you can easily avoid it. I realized what would be OP is a little feature that people kind of forgot of, or at least I forgot of, the killer bunny. So, rabbits are already hard enough to kill because they're hard to hit hitboxes and because they're really fast, but I modified them to be even faster. Now, I didn't change its health, so if you land a successful hit on the rabbit, it's going to die immediately. The next attack is actually really, it's a harder attack. Yeah, they're vexes, but with pumpkin heads and iron armor, which you can't see. Now, our second to last attack is a weird attack. It's basically an area effect cloud which summons at your feet. Now, this area effect cloud gives you the wither effect for a 10 second. Now, if you're not careful enough, it will also spawn on top of you, which means that if you're running or something, you will get affected by that as well. Of course, if you bring a milk bucket to the fight, you will be fine. Now, this last attack is a little weird one. You know when you get close to bosses, you take damage from them. In this case, you get instant damage. Now, that's when you get about 2 blocks away from the boss. Now, this attack basically sucks you towards the boss, and in the process, will give you instant damage. And if you manage to get away, you're lucky, but you better regen it quickly or else you're gonna die. But yeah, that's basically it. I decided maybe to make the boss a little harder. If you're in a 50 block radius of this mob, I wanted to give them negative effects. And those negative effects are weakness, slowness, and mining fatigue. So it's harder to fight the boss as well as trying to get away from the boss. But yeah, now that we finished with the attacks, we need to create natural attacks. And basically what I mean by natural is RNG. RNG is random number generator, and I'm trying to use RNG for randomized attacks because each attack has an ID. I decided to use the loot table type of RNG because you have a chance of getting this, you have a chance of getting that, you know, wither skeleton heads and all that stuff. And yeah, so using this RNG, I decided to test it out before putting in the boss. I put it on the boss, and it works, which is awesome. So there is a 10 second timer between every single boss attack, which means that you have time to attack. So our next step is to model it to code the rest, because we need to know the hitbox, we need to know the health, we need to know how it looks when it dies. So I'm just gonna time lapse it. I decided to make it look like a witch, have that witch hat, you know, have that ugly clothes. And after that, I'm going to... I'm gonna have to make the boss look more Halloween. And I'm gonna wear it down, which means I'm gonna like rip it and stuff and all that stuff. I'm also gonna make a hurt model, which is basically just painting over the model by just making red. I also modeled the markers, the lightning and the pumpkin marker. And there's a symbol for lightning and there's a symbol for a pumpkin. So going into Minecraft, I see that the boss worked. Now here we go, making the hitbox. The best hitbox I can think of is the Iron Golem hitbox. If I make it have no AI, it won't attack at all and will just serve as a hitbox. Because, it won't actually attack you until it attacked, or it won't attack you until you hit a villager. Which means that if you just set it to no AI, nothing happens, just a hitbox. Now, the next thing to do is the boss bar. Now, of course, if you do a slash boss bar command, it's for the boss, you know? But the reason why I don't want to do it is because the boss bar can only work for one entity. And I don't really like that because players may be summoning entities all over the place. And so I decided to use title text instead. Now, I used the action bar, and the action bar is basically just going to show the health. So basically, I decided to make the health 500. After it hit zero, I basically run a command which detects if it dies. And basically, when I detect if it dies, it triggers the death command. Now, I decided I don't know what the name should be called, so I just made it obfuscated, which is that weird text right there. But yeah, anyway, so the death animation is really weird. It's just someone screaming, laughing, and then there's explosions, which drops some very special loot, which I'm not gonna show you. So now I'm going to make the sound. Basically, I decided I'm going to download some royalty-free music, which is gonna be scary, which is gonna be like the epic boss fight type of music. I'll just leave the link in the description for you guys to check it out. I'll also add a little spooky laugh when it spawns as well. But yeah, that's basically it for the boss. But yeah, guys, that's basically it. If you'd like to see more content like this, please like and subscribe, which would be very appreciated. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!